couple offensive linemen out today with Trey Smith, Brett Kendrick, and Marcus Tatum. They'll all be back. Some of them may be back tomorrow, and maybe Sunday, and maybe on Tuesday, but nothing significant. Some kind of precautionary of holding them out. But again, we need to get them back. In terms of practice-wise, I think the big thing overall is just consistency, especially on offense. Too many dropped footballs today. We threw a lot at our offense in terms of blitz pickup and a lot of different things that we're doing differently defensively. And so they had a lot thrown at them today, but we have to continue to grow and get better. But I like the mentality of our football team, and really challenge them coming off an off day and starting fast the way we started today with our walkthrough and all that, and they were able to do that.
With Chance being out, how confident do you still feel about the offensive line?
Oh, very confident. And, it's valuable reps that these kids are getting right now, and they're having a lot thrown at them. And obviously, we'll get those three individuals back here in a day or two. But, it's continuity, and we got to keep that competitive battle going, so we need to get them back.
Looking at the defensive line, talk about Shai Tuttle, what we've seen from him.
Shai's continuing to progress. He's working individual drills. He's not done any team activities yet, but he continues to progress, and very, very encouraged with what we see so far.
But you said that he'll be day by day with Shai. Is he even doing a little more than you thought he would do over the course of the last month, 6 weeks?
Yeah, I would say he's maybe a little bit ahead of schedule. But again, he's doing the individual. He's doing some movements, and you can see him getting better and better each day with his movement, so that's been encouraging.
You more confident? I'm not talking about playing in the opener. I'm just talking about being available to him at some point in time.
Oh, yeah. It's really encouraging when you get him out here, and he's in full pads today, and he's going doing individual drills with his teammates. That's extremely encouraging. And, he's worked very, very hard, but also you can see the excitement in him as well, in his demeanor.
Coach, can you talk about Latrell Williams and what you had out of him the first week of football game?
Yeah, we thought Latrell had one of the better springs of any of our receivers. He's picked it up where he left off. The big thing for him is just consistency in route running, consistency in catching the football. We all know he's very, very explosive, and he works exceptionally hard, as do all of our players. And been pleased in terms of the work ethic and the mentality of our receiver core. The big thing, though, is one drop is too many. As we know, a drop in our offense is basically the equivalent of a turnover. It stifles your momentum, and we can't have that. And that gets back to the discipline and the things of being a football team that don't beat itself. But I've been very encouraged with Latrell all throughout camp so far, through practice five, as I have been the entire receiving group.
So what about Tyler Bird? What have you seen from him?
Yeah, a little more intensity, a little more focus than the spring. And obviously, he played a lot of meaningful reps for us in games last year as a true freshman. We need that experience, and we need him to continue to grow. And he's been able to do that. He's now wanting to be on special teams as well. And his attitude has been outstanding. His work ethic has been outstanding. So again, I see him getting better and better.
Is he playing mostly on the outside, or is he still playing some slot?
He's playing slot right now. We'll mix it up a little bit on the outside as well, and that's a thing. We require all of our receivers to know all the positions.
What's the biggest office coach tight end? Seems like a place where you can use another body. Have you seen enough from him yet to know if he can help you early?
Well, it's all happening very fast. But what we see is a very talented young man, very, very explosive, great center of gravity, tough, and has very, very good ball skills. So we just need to continue to progress with him day by day. But he is an individual that we anticipate that could help us in that.
Seen enough already to make you feel like you made the right decision, offense versus defense?
Absolutely.
What's the biggest difference you see in Congbo now versus a year ago?
Confidence. He's playing a lot faster, and that just comes with experience and repetitions. He's worked very, very hard. He understands the standard and the expectations. And, I think that's when you have individuals in your room and you come in, like a Corey Green, like a Derek Barnett. They kind of lead the way, and that's really transcendent on our defensive front. They take great, great pride in the way they play, the way they prepare. And Jonathan now is one of those individuals who's holding everyone accountable like they all do in that room.
Coach, Kevin Booker said he's been impressed by Ty Chandler. What have you seen from him?
Yeah, I see him just like Latrell Bumpus, getting better and better and better every single day, picking it up. has been able to handle the workload in terms of a playbook. The installation has great retention and has the ability to make you miss. Has great burst and explosion, center of gravity. Did a great job today in blitz pickup, so we're really excited about him. And again, this freshman class, they've done a really good job of following our veterans, but they're starting to step up, and you can see they got a competitive nature to them. And just, you know, all three of the freshman running backs have been really, really pleased to see them come out here and play, and we're going to need all three of them to play for us.
Good to get Petulli and Kirkland back out there.
Yeah, they both those individuals went through individual today and all that, so it was good.
Coach, we seem to ask you this every time we talk to you, but what's been your storyline, you know, so far through fall camp?
Well, I think the big thing for this football team is just maintaining our level of consistency day in and day out. And there can be no 4 days, especially, you know, when you have an off day now. Every practice rep counts. And right now they're juggling a lot. We're still in summer school. And that's why it'll be great to get to this weekend and really have kind of a full training camp feel for it on Saturday and Sunday. And then we flip the script again, and then they're back to going to school for one more week. I think that makes it challenging, but also, you know, we talk about details, accountability, and toughness, and that challenges your toughness, but just a high level of consistency day in and day out, and these individuals continue to compete.